used in, not all counties, but in this county, it's a traditional, older way of saying to the county, we need the levy money. That's really all this is. So the numbers are based on 16, that's not necessarily what you're going to approve when our real budget comes through. This is strictly a tax budget, meaning we're justifying the need for the levy funds. We all know we need the levy funds, but this is the piece of paper that explains to the county in their format.
Are there any questions for Finance Director on that issue? And the rest of them, earnestly, we say the resolution about application to participate in our public presentation to participate in the ODOT Winter Contract for road salt, 2022-2023 season. And we'll need a motion to add this evening, and we can add it as legislation under Local 52404. Again, Ms. Betty Ritter, you want to talk about that at all?
Sure. ODOT, once a year comes through, and they say by May 31st, you must give us your commitment of your salt quantity so that they're able to put it out for bid for the winter season that's coming up in, you know, like 9 months from now. But if we don't commit to them, then we're not locked in, or we won't have the ability to buy at the state price. So that's why now is the time to do that. The quantity that we're asking for permission for is the same exact quantity that we just submitted for this last winter.
And if you want to address the legislation 05.402 regarding the community block grant?
Sure, the community block grant funds that we're asking the county for are really for playground equipment. We'd ask the county to grant us $75,000, and the community playground equipment would go to Robertsville Community Park and Woodland Drive Park. If we're giving the people here the money.
Yes. Are there any questions for the Finance Director regarding those issues? Seeing none, the Council of the Whole Committee concluded at 7:03. We'll now move to the regular council meeting.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, I'm calling the meeting to order at 7:04. Is there anybody recording this evening's meeting? Mr. Tricia, is it video or audio? Please make sure your cell phones are on that grid of silence. And that will be on for the purpose of all.
Mr. Kern?
Yes.
Mr. Sadden?
Here.
Mr. Schindel?
Here.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Akeley is absent and excused. Mr. Pledge?
Here.
Is there a motion to approve the minutes of regular council meeting of May 10th, 2016?
Motion to approve.
Is there a second? Will the clerk please call the roll?
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Sadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Mr. Evers?
Abstain.
Mr. Pledge?
Yes, minutes are approved. Next, the President's report. The next scheduled council of the committee is scheduled for Tuesday, June 14th, 2016. And so, now the regular council meeting is called, and the general council is open to this meeting. This past weekend, we had the raising of the flags for the board of flags, and the beautification committee came out. A lot of volunteers, the actual donors donated several dozen donors to make sure everybody had some freshness. And beautiful day, and the flags, I think, were put up in about 45 minutes. It was really a great community effort, and it's my great thank you to everybody who came out and supported us. And with that, we'll move on to communication and petitions. Will the clerk please read communication and petitions?
A communication from Finance Director Schindel on the affirmatively further fair housing in the city of Eastlake, Lake County, Ohio.
This was discussed in Council of the Whole Committee when we added to this evening's agenda.
A communication from Finance Director Schindel regarding an application with the Lake County Planning Commission for funds through the Competitive Community Development Block Program.
This was discussed in Council of the Whole Committee when we added to this evening's agenda.
A communication from Finance Director Schindel to accept the tax budget 2017.
This was discussed with council, the whole committee will be edited this evening's agenda.
A communication from Finance Director Schindel to enter into an agreement to participate with the Ohio Department of Transportation through the ODOT Winter Contract for road salt for the 2016-2017 winter season.
This was also discussed with council, the whole committee will be edited this evening's agenda. With that, we would move on to committee reports. If there were no committee reports held since our last city council meeting, is there any council members?
Yes, I want to make, thank you, President. I wanted to make two comments. The first was I want to offer a thank you to the beautification committee. They met for the third time this year, which this past was kind of Saturday. They met from 10 to 1 o'clock. They weeded the grounds at City Hall, planted flowers, planted rose bushes. I think it looks outstanding. They did a great job, and I just wanted to say that the work was noticed and very appreciated.
Is there any questions from the chief man? Does anybody else want to say
that? Yes. That's a brief. I have a brief report from the Port Authority. The Port Authority is finalizing a lease for the Chagrin River Library, which is the canoe and kayak rental facility down there. It's been out of business for the last couple of years, but it's going to be back in business this summer, it looks like. So that's good news. So I encourage anyone to use that if you get the opportunity this summer.
Is there a second?
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes, that item is added to the agenda. Okay, with that, that concludes our committee reports. I don't think I forgot anything this time, my writing is not very good, so. All right, with that, all right, so with that, we will move on to recognition of the public, 1.5 hour, 3 minutes per person. I remind speakers that all remarks will be directed to the chair, will not involve personalities, and are limited, again, to 3 minutes per person or 30 minutes total. There is no one signed up to speak this evening. Is there anybody wishing to address council? Okay. With that, we will move on to legislation proposed.
A resolution recognizing the broad duty to affirmatively further fair housing in the city of Eastlake, Lake County, Ohio, and declaring an emergency.
Is there a motion to suspend the rule requiring second readings and raise the floor?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Will the clerk please call the roll?
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Is there a motion to adopt?
Move to adopt.
Is there a second?
Second.
Call roll.
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Motion carried. Legislation is adopted. Will the clerk please read 05402?
A resolution authorizing the mayor and director of finance to file an application with the Lake County Planning Commission for funds to the Competitive Comm Development Block Grant Program for the term of October 1st, 2016 through September 30th, 2017, and declaring an emergency.
Is there a motion to suspend the rule requiring second readings and raise the floor?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Will the clerk please call roll?
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Is there a motion to adopt?
Move to adopt.
Is there a second?
Will the clerk
please call roll?
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Motion carried. Legislation is adopted. Will the clerk please read 052403?
A resolution accepting the tax budget for 2017 is presented by the Director of Finance and declaring an emergency.
Is there a motion to suspend the rule requiring second readings in full? Readings in full.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Will the clerk please call roll?
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Is there a motion to adopt?
Move to adopt.
Is there a second?
Second.
Will the clerk please call roll?
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Motion carried. Legislation is adopted. Will the clerk please read 052404?
A resolution authorizing and directing the mayor and director of finance to enter into an agreement to participate with the Ohio Department of Transportation to participate in the ODOT Winter Contract 018-17 for road salt for the 2016-2017 winter season and declaring an emergency.
Is there a motion to suspend the rule requiring second readings and raise the floor?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Please call.
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Is there a motion to adopt?
Move to adopt.
Is there a second?
Second.
Will the clerk please call?
Mr. Evers?
Yes.
Mr. Zern?
Yes.
Mr. Spadden?
Yes.
Mr. Kasunik?
Yes.
Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Ms. DePledge?
Yes. Motion carried. Legislation is adopted. There is no legislation pending. There is no unfinished business. No new business. We will move on to the administrative report, I think being from our mayor and safety director, Dennis Morrow.
Thank you, Madam President. Welcome to this evening's meeting to our residents. Sorry about the warmth in here. Obviously, we're having some issues with our HVAC. We're trying to get Honeywell out here to take a look at it, so I can apologize for that. But we have a Memorial Day service on Monday, May 30th at 11 a.m. With the city, DFW 3863, American Legion Post 678, so that'll be in the back of the gazebo. I too would like to thank the Beautification Committee and the Boulevard 500 Flags Committee for all the work they've done over the last few weeks. Also, I'd like to say and tell about all the work that's being done out front. There's no city funds there for that. That is being paid by the Boulevard 500 Flags from their various fundraisers and the money that they get donated. Dave and myself helped one of our businesses. We went out to the county that they were having some issues with some sewer work and some fees, so we met with the county a couple weeks ago and took care of that and helped one of our businesses out. I've been walking and going to some of our new businesses that are to the city and some of our old to welcome to our city and thank the businesses that are in our city currently and asking if there's anything that we can do to help them become better. That concludes my report. I'm open for questions.
Thank you, Madam President. Just a couple things. Appreciate everybody that came out for Gary Radbank's funeral. For those who don't know, one of our retired members passed away. He had a short battle with cancer, but I know the American needs some support, and we were able to really do a couple of nice things for the family as close to honor and that thing. But if you knew Gary was definitely one of a kind of a guy. He was a little, he had his own way of doing things. He had his own way of speaking and his own dialect and that type of thing. But he did definitely serve this community very proudly. I had the privilege to work with them, and he never had a dull moment when you were with him. So we always, you know, there's plenty of stories that come out of the fire station that starts out with, remember when Gary did this and that type of thing. So, you know, his family is doing well, and we'll continue to support them. So I appreciate our support for that. I just mentioned, I know everybody's aware that we did have a fire the other night that did have a death. We're still waiting to get some additional information from the coroner's office and that type of thing. The police and the fire departments are continue to work on that. And again, one thing we can do to the families to support them. And then finally, the last thing, I know that, you know, working with the police chief and the mayor, we continue to prepare for the RNC. And it seems like it's a little bit adds to the element every single day. So we continue to be on top of that, branch driver to be on top of that. So other than that, we'll have questions.
Any questions for the chief of administration possible?
Thank you. Just to let you know, there will be no BZA or planning commission meetings this week.
Any questions for chief of men?
Thank you, Madam President, members of the Council, Mayor. Bids for Ridgewood Drive renewed next week on June 1st. The opinion problem the cost for that is $600,000. OPWC has 50% grant to us for that work. If you look outside the front of City Hall, Lake County is currently performing a water main improvement. They're doing some service connections across the street here. They'll be working down in the intersection of Erie Road and Lakeshore Boulevard. The contract will be running through about the end of July, which time should wrap up. Shortly after that finishes, ODOT's going to start an overlay project. Sometime after July 4th, it'll go from the front of City Hall and head out west to Willowbrook. With that, open for questions.
Any questions for Mr. Blair?